The work that we're doing with respect to screening is important work in terms of moving this forward. The recommendation is to provide screening in a regular routine primary care visit or in a whenever the patient has contact with a healthcare provider. We have evidence-based established screening tools, for example, for depression, for anxiety, for alcohol use, for drug use. And the recommendation is to have those as part of standard practice so that those questions and information is being obtained at the same time that you're taking the blood pressure or the pulse and the weight of an individual when they come into the office for the healthcare visit. So it should be part of standard practice. Those screening tools are intended to identify people who may be at risk. And once they're identified to be at risk, we know that there's also interventions that we can provide within that, if it's a primary care visit or if it's a hospitalization, the nurse can have what I call simply a conversation with a person and to let them know what their results were in that screening and how those results are placing them potentially at risk and what can be done about that, whether it's an intervention that's able to be provided right there within the clinic setting, or if it's something that's more potentially more serious and requires a referral for further assessment and evaluation and treatment in a specialty program.